moving on from harmony at the level of human being, getting clarity about the human being, getting to know the reality that a human being is not equal to just the body, but a human being is a coexistence of self and body. Now, we all know that we are interacting with others. This human interaction we are having thoroughly. So this relationship is something which is very, very important. Till now, we have looked at what is necessary for each one of us as a human being. As a human being, physical facility is necessary but not sufficient for me. Relationships are at a higher priority. And in order to ensure fulfillment in relationship, this right understanding, just now Sir was also mentioning, that this right understanding is definitely needed to be at the highest priority so that I can live in relationship, I can ensure happiness for myself, I can ensure happiness for the other, and I can utilize the physical facility in the right way. We also, in the previous sessions, have talked about this human being as a coexistence of self and body with our students. Now the students also have this clarity that the needs of the self are in continuity. So happiness is something which I want in continuity, which can be fulfilled by right understanding and right feeling. And the physical facility is only required to nurture the body, to protect the body, and rightly utilize the body. Are you able to see for yourself that the need for the physical facility is limited? What do you say? Let us take one quick response on this. So any of our participants who would like to respond, okay, Jayanti ji, Dr. P. Jayanti ji, would you like to respond to this? Are you able to see that the need for the physical facility is limited? Okay, maybe we are not able to reach you. Usha ma'am, Dr. Usha Kumari ji, would you like to interact?
Yes, yes, ma'am. Physical facility is limited. We need limited quantity of physical facility. We have to identify the required physical facility, but through right understanding.
Very nice. Two different people may have different amount of requirement. That is, of course, possible. I may have a different set of requirement. The other may have a different amount of requirement. But still, for myself, am I able to see that the need for physical facility is limited? That is something which I can check for myself. Now, with this clarity, let's look into relationships, the right understanding of the feelings in relationship. And to facilitate our students, right? These students, they're coming up from their families. Within their own families, they must have gone through so many things. Within their friend circle, right? They are at such an age that they are coming across all these issues which are bothering them. So let's ask this simple question. Do we want to be in relationship or opposition? What do you think? Do we want to be in relationship or in opposition? Let us have some responses from you.
Yes, ma'am. We want to be in relationship. That is naturally acceptable.
So on the basis of our own natural acceptance, right, we are looking at various proposals. Each one of us is mentioning we want to be in relationship. Maybe in the morning when I left home, I might have had some contradiction with my family members. But whenever asked this, do we want to be in relationship or opposition? The answer that I get is the same. I want to be in relationship. I may not be able to. So as a student, we are discussing it with them that we all are part of family. We are living in family. So this family is the basic building block of the human organization, right? Now, when we say family, is this family only related to blood relatives or can it extend to more than that? What do you think when we say family? We can ask these little questions to students to help them explore that what does this family means? Okay, so it is beyond the blood relation, okay? Family, we are getting so many responses. It includes our friends also, batchmates, and so on. Now, how do we want to live with them? With all of them? with your own parents, with your own siblings, with your own colleagues? How do you want to live them? With them, with fulfillment or without fulfillment? What is naturally acceptable to each one of us? Can that answer change from person to person? Let me ask this to you all. If you ask your own students, will it vary from one student to the other student? We all want to live with fulfillment. Now this, whenever we are talking about this harmony in the family, right? It is one human being interacting with the other, right? So it is this interaction of the two individuals. And in order to ensure the fulfillment, it is very essential for each one of us to understand relationship. Gee, very nice. Very nice. So we can just see that this relationship, what do you think? The relationship is already there or we are creating it? We can ask this to our students, right? That you were born in a family. Did you actually do anything to create relationship or it was already there? What do you think? Let us take some response from you. What do you think? The relationship, are you creating it or it is already there? Rupali ji, would you like to interact?
Yeah, ma'am. Didi, actually, I feel that natural acceptance for everybody is fulfillment and to be in relationship and not in a position. But if we look at, so by and large, this is true. But for certain people, though they may accept or don't accept, it is like when they fight, they get a kind of boost. Like, when they oppose, they get a kind of, boost. So for example, if we take an example of Shakuni in Mahabharata. So for him, what was his natural acceptance? Because he always tried to, make Kauravas, against Pandavas and all. So kind of villains which we talk about. Is it that their natural acceptance naturally is something else? Or how it is? So that is what I want to
say. Rupali, let's look at this. For Shakuni also, he had acceptance of relationship for some, and therefore he was trying to ignore the others or trying to harm the others so that he can save interest for some.
Okay.
I am accepting my relationship, I am working thoroughly for them in whatever way I want to.
Okay.
Right? So if I don't have this clarity within me, I may do something wrong.
Okay.
Right?
Okay.
As per the example which you just mentioned, we can just see that he could not see his relationship beyond Kauravas.
Okay.
And therefore he was working thoroughly for Kauravas.
Okay. Right? Because he loved Kauravas very much and he couldn't see.
It means he's able to identify the relationship with one part and not able to see the relationship with the other part.
Okay.
So there may be mistakes in relationship.
And the people who always oppose, maybe they are doing it because of preconditioning or something like that. That at every, any point that you put up.
Whosoever is trying to oppose or trying to dominate, we can just see ultimately what he is trying to do, trying to make the other in consensus with him by this domination. Right? Wanting to try to establish the relationship with whatever understanding he has created or gross misunderstanding he has created within himself.
Okay.
But there is this want for relationship, right?
Yes.
So the natural acceptance is to be in relationship. But if I don't have a clarity about relationship, I may do errors.
Yes.
While executing my relationships.
Yes.
Very nice.
Yeah, thank you. Yeah, I got my answer. Yeah.
So we all can see that relationship is something which is naturally acceptable. But if I don't have clarity about relationships, while executing, while expressing it, I may do some errors. The same goes with the other also. Right? So we were looking at this, whether this relationship is already there or we are creating it. Gautamji, would you like to interact quickly? Professor Gautamji, would you like to interact? Maybe we are not able to reach, sir. Okay, we'll take up further. So when we say relationship is, We can just ask, yes. So many I'm already mentioning in the chat that the relationship is already there. We may recognize it. We may not recognize it because I may be in that unaware state where I am unable to recognize it. Now, who is having this relationship? When I'm talking about this relationship, is it this relationship between oneself and the other self? Using this body as a mode to express, or this relationship is between one body and the other? Let us take some of the reflections for ourselves. Jayashree ma'am wants to communicate. So ma'am, we'll provide you with the mic. We can't see your hand being raised, and that's why we can't provide you with the mic. If you raise your hand, we'll try to provide you with the mic at the earliest.
Ma'am, now you are able to hear me, ma'am?
Ji, Jayashree, ma'am, please.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, you called me before, so I was willing to tell certain things. I was having a doubt in the question, ma'am, that we have done as a quiz. The self is the instrument of the body, or there was a question going on. I just want the proper explanation for that.
Okay, maybe we'll take detailed explanation in the practice session, but right now when you are talking to me
about the relationship,
you are asking about self as an instrument of body, right?
Yes, ma'am. Yes.
Okay. So I'm just asking, when you're communicating with me, right?
Okay, ma'am.
When you're communicating with me, you are making some decision to put forth the question. You are choosing some words.
Okay.
Right? And yes, then you are giving this instruction to your vocal cords to produce a particular sound.
Yes, ma'am. Right?
So that the words come out, I'm able to hear those words.
Okay.
Right? So who is giving this direction? Self or body?
It's a self.
And who is following the instructions?
A body, I suppose.
So who is the instrument?
Self is the instrument of the body.
Let's check again.
Okay, body is the instrument, fine.
Who is following the instructions?
My body is following the instructions, but right, actually I have a doubt. With the self, your mind, you're telling that the brain is which is acting, or it's myself.
So are you there? Could you see that you are there?
Yes.
And your body is there?
Yes, ma'am.
Right. So whatever material is the body, brain being a material entity is a part of body.
Yes.
And you are the self.
Okay, fine.
Right. So now you are making that decision to communicate with me, and you are giving instructions to the body. You unmuted yourself. You chose words.
Okay.
Right. But that unmute, for unmuting, you used your hand. You used your body. Right.
Okay.
Now you are using the instrument.
Yes, ma'am. Yes, I'm clearly understood.
Gee, very nice.
Thank you very much, ma'am.
So I hope our participants are able to answer to this question which is being put. Can we talk about these feelings with definiteness? So many are saying that yes, they can. Some are saying feelings are abstract. We'll keep it open because we are in process of exploring. For our students also, we'll get these kinds of answers from the students also, right? Where the students can see that these feelings in relationship are in one self for the other self. Some may agree to it, some may not agree to it. So we should allow them to explore, right? So now let us see, in this whole process of exploration, let us facilitate our students, you being the students, right? And these questions are coming to you now. So what is naturally acceptable to you? Feeling of trust or mistrust? What do you think? Right? Feeling of respect or disrespect? Right? We can ask our students to put forth what is naturally acceptable. So let me ask Dr. Rajaram Mohapatraji. Sir, what do you think? Which feelings are naturally acceptable to you? Would you like to interact? विश्वास जी, यू हैव द माइक विद यू.
हेलो मैम.
जी जी राजा.
मैं ऑडिबल?
यस यू आर.
यस So I would like to say that I am very much clear that now the body is the instrument of the self, and with proper self-regulation, proper self-discipline, we can regulate the body, and we cannot be dependent on the body's desire, as we can explore within ourselves to strengthen ourselves and rely on ourselves.
Very nice. Rajaram sir, which feelings are naturally acceptable to you? Would you like to respond to this also?
Yes, feelings like trust, respect, gratitude, love, these are all naturally acceptable to me.
Ji, very nice sir. And this is something which we are getting answers from within, right?
Exactly.
We are able to refer to our own natural acceptance. For the student also, we can ask the student to verify for himself, are these feelings abstract or definite, right? What is naturally acceptable to you? Is trust naturally acceptable to you or mistrust? Vishwas wants to say something.
Madam, my answer was, I raised my hand so to the previous question which you raised regarding to the feelings, madam, expression of feeling.
Ji.
My intention is to tell that so when we are very sad, and so maybe that sadness may be very personal, we may not feel to express it to anybody else. Mm-hmm. And when we want a solution to our sadness, we may explore it, and we may try to discuss with our close friends to explore a solution. Mm-hmm. And even in the case of happiness, we may want to share it with our friends so that so we could multiply it. So that is what I want to express regarding feeling. So it is a totally a state of unstability, or we cannot just conclude that whether we can share it or not. So it depends totally on our state of mind, that we are in the state of sadness or happiness, whether we want to share it or not. So it is totally uncertain, madam. That is what I want to express.
Vishwas sir, uncertain in what terms? I couldn't get that clearly.
I just said it, madam. So if it is purely personal, and I don't want to discuss it with any of our friends or neighbors or friends, or even relatives.
Okay.
So that I stated as uncertainty.
Do you want to mention that these feelings cannot be recognized?
No, I have the understanding of my feeling.
Ji.
But I do not want to share it. So because it is purely personal.
Fine. You don't feel like sharing, but when you are unhappy, do you want to continue in that state, or do you want to resolve?
No, I want a problem, but I am in a state of finding it, and I want to resolve it on my own.
Ji.
But I do not want to share it with any others. I want to keep it purely personal.
That's okay. That's fine. You're not sharing it with the other. You're feeling. But are these feelings there within you?
These yes, feelings yes. Which are definitely. I am undergoing it. I am in a consequence of understanding it. I want to face it. I want to recover from it. Ji. And I want to have a solution of it.
So this unhappiness, this contradiction within you, right? That
yes,
might
yes.
be because at a given point of time, some kind of a feeling is lacking.
Yes.
Right? So maybe that, suppose there is some lack of affection for someone. So you can feel that gap within you, and you want to ensure, or you want to get rid of that, right? With that clarity.
Definitely.
So if I have this clarity of feelings within me, I'm able to resolve myself.
Yes, yes. But with respect to sharing it, it is uncertainty. That is what I'm just pointing it out, madam.
We are not sharing. We are expressing. When I have the feelings, we are able to express it. But if I don't have the feelings, I'm unable to express. Right? If I'm able to express it to the other, I am happy and I make the other happy.
Yes, madam.
Nice.
Thank you, madam.
So we all can see what are the naturally acceptable feelings for us. Right? Now, when we have these feelings within us, we are able to see that it leads to our happiness. Right? Are you able to observe that? If I have this feeling of trust within me, will it make me happy or not? What do you think? You can put some responses in the chat. So if I ensure I hope I'm audible.
Yes,
May I, am I audible?
Yes, it's not audible. May I share, Didi? Slide.
Yes, you have to share the slide. Raining yes. continuously, so electricity has gone.
Just a minute.
So, the complaints which we have in relationship, why are we having these complaints in relationship? Is it because of some kind of an absence of these feelings? What do you think? Whenever we have some kind of complaints. So could you see these complaints which we observe? So suppose I have some kind of an issue with my spouse or with my sibling. How do we try to compensate for that? How do we try to get rid of that complaint? Are we looking at feelings in relationship, or we just try to compensate it with some kind of a physical facility? What do you think? What are we doing? Right? So suppose your spouse is annoyed, right? Having some complaints in relationship. Now, what do you try to do? Do you try to look at the issue, which kind of feeling is going missing, or you end up in the evening coming with some gift? Does that work? We can ask our students. So suppose you have a friend, right? And your friend is somehow having some kind of issue, right? Not happy with you. And at that point, how do you try to compensate? If you try to give a gift, will that really work? What do you think? Some are saying initiating. You try to give some gift to your friend and try to resolve it. Will that physical facility work to compensate for the complaint in relationship? We all agree to this. We can ask this to students also, right? This is something which the students can also respond, that if we try to compensate it, let us look at the whole analysis of the current state, right? In the current state, Priya, can we move to next slide? See, we are very much unhappy because we are not getting clarity about these feelings. With this gross misunderstanding that the human being is equal to a body and the needs of the body can be fulfilled by physiochemical things. Can the needs of self be fulfilled by physiochemical things? What do you think? Now, in the current scenario, we are expecting the others to express the feelings. If the others are expressing these feelings, then we feel happy. And if the other is unable to express that feeling, we are feeling unhappy. We are trying to, for example, this respect. Right? In order to ensure that respect, we try to copy someone's appearance, language, lifestyle, right? Somebody else's way of walking, talking, so that we can ensure this feeling of respect. Do we need to ensure this feeling within ourselves, or can we continue expecting these feelings from the other? What do you think? Sangeeta ji is saying within ourselves, right? Within ourselves. Sanobar Sultana ji is also mentioning within ourselves. Very nice. So it's just like that each one of us is begging for respect and everyone's bowl is empty. Are you able to see this? Let us take some response regarding this. So, Bhaiya, can we launch the poll? What is your opinion about all what is said? While you are responding to this, we'll take some reflection from our participants. So, Lopa Mudraji, Lordu Mary Kundriji, sorry. You have the mic with you. Or maybe Dr. Babita, would you like to interact? Babita ji, would you like to interact?
Ji, ma'am. Completely in agreement to what is being discussed, the feeling of respect. लेकिन फिर भी मतलब कई बार as we interact with especially you know come back to my personal scenario have these children of one is a teenager and one is still in the primary school I always found this teenager on the edge I mean especially with the younger one छोटी छोटी चीजों के लिए उसके साथ you know to get into a discussion they get physical की लड़ाई झगड़ा ये वो सो नॉर्मली ऑल्दो आई मेक बोथ ऑफ देम सिट टुगेदर बट देन व्हाई डू यू वांट आई मीन इफ इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ हिज एज ही आल्सो डिजर्व्स रिस्पेक्ट इन बॉडी लैंग्वेज फ्रॉम यू इन योर वर्ड्स एंड आई एम श्योर इट विल कम बैक टू यू द रेसिप्रोकेशन विल हैपन तो कई बार मैम मुझे लगता है कि It also happens with us also, especially agar hum ek setup mein hain, the elders have this rights to be rude to us, to disobey that small individual in the younger one. And that is probably some of the reasons that we get unhappy. But if I know that I am worthy of it and somebody's bad behavior, jaise ma'am humne humare usme bhi dekha, जो हमारा असाइनमेंट टू में वीडियो था राइट हियर वाला जो वीडियो है कि किसी के थोड़े से भी बिहेवियर से या ऊंचा बोलने से या कुछ से वी टेक इट वेरी पर्सनली एंड द एंटायर डे गेट स्पॉइल्ड एंड वी ट्रिगर अ चेन रिएक्शन मतलब मुझे किसी ने कुछ कहा इतना फ्रजाइल मैंने खुद को समझा मतलब लिया और फिर उसको आगे बढ़ाया मतलब जो मुझसे कमजोर था उस पर उसने उससे कमजोर था उस पर So I think that is what happens, ma'am. And even in class, when we share, our students are able to relate to it. कि एक छोटी सी बात किसी की और आपका पूरा दिन खराब करती है because you keep on contemplating it, and you also start आप भी उसी का उसको आगे बढ़ाते हो मतलब खुद तो जा ही रहे हो आप एक विशेष सर्कल में लेकिन फिर आप ये नहीं सोचते कि अगर मुझे ये बुरा लग रहा है सो लेट मी नॉट टेक इट फॉरवर्ड फिर आप उसे उसी धारा में आगे भी बढ़ते हैं
सो वी ऑल कैन सी दैट वी लैक दिस क्लैरिटी ऑफ दीस फीलिंग्स इन रिलेशनशिप एंड वी आर मिस कम्युनिकेटिंग विद दिस ग्रॉस मिसअंडरस्टैंडिंग दैट द अदर इज इक्वल टू बॉडी
यस
वेरी ट्रू एंड दैट क्लैरिटी इज नीडेड फॉर ईच वन ऑफ अस इररिस्पेक्टिव ऑफ द एज It's not that I should get the clarity and the child cannot have that clarity.
Yes, ma'am.
Very nice. So we all can see that if we don't have that clarity, we create confusions for ourselves and for the others too. So whatever is being said, we can just see that so many agree to this, that they also feel the same way. Some of us are saying that they don't feel the same way. So if they want to say something, of course, they're most welcome to put their own view and we'll keep it open to see that in the current scenario, are we expecting all these feelings from the others? Somehow everyone should respect me. They should give me this feeling of respect. They should ensure this for me. And in that case, each one of us is begging for respect, everyone's bowl being empty. So in order to strengthen these feelings within ourselves, the most fundamental thing is to understand these feelings. To understand these feelings so that we can ensure these feelings and express these feelings to the others and rightly evaluate the feelings, that will lead to mutual happiness. So with this, we are going to look at this whole feeling of trust. Right? Trust, the foundational value. In the introductory workshop, we have gone into details of this trust. So let us take this trust. This trust as a proposal is to be assured of. Assured of what? That the other wants to make me happy and prosperous. I have this clarity. Now, since we have this discussion in the introductory workshop and we asked these questions to you all, I'm putting forth these four questions in front of you. And again, we'll take the response, right? We are doing this for the students right now. So we'll take your response. And in the meanwhile, we'll be interacting with you about what do you make out of this trust? When do we say that? Are we able to see that the other is there to make me happy? So let us hear from you. Veena ji, how will you help the students get clarity with this? Would you like to interact, Veena ji? Suryakant sir, you have the mic with you.
Yeah, madam.
Ji sir.
Madam, anyway, that my question is related to self and body. Anyway, the present context, I will speak it later if opportunity is given, madam.
Okay, sir. Self and body.
Extend, madam, my discussion with respect to self and body.
Okay, sir.
Yeah, madam, just a minute. So we know that the body is made up of millions of cells and it is self-organized. Even I heard it from the Padmasri, Dr. B.M. Hegde video, YouTube video. And also you referred, madam, there is a coordination, self-organization between the millions of cells of the body. Okay, madam. And we know that body is the self, body is the instrument of the self. Means it is, we can think of it as a master which is controlling the body. So, and is there any situation where self is not in harmony with the body?
There can be a number of situations when I lack clarity, I may not ensure feeling of self-regulation and the self and body may not be in harmony. But sir, surely we'll take up this discussion in the practice session. Will that be fine, sir?
Yeah, madam. Yeah, madam.
We'll be deviating a bit from the content right now.
Okay, madam. Okay. Okay.
So
thank you.
Let us look at all these questions where we are evaluating trust between ourselves and someone who is very close to us. And we're looking at these four questions. I want to make myself happy. I want to make the other always happy. The other wants to make himself, herself always happy. And the other wants to make me always happy. And you all are putting your responses to these. So let us hear from Tapasmini ji. You have the mic with you. Or Vinayak ji, you have raised your hand, Vinayak ji. Would you like to interact? Veena ji is unmuted, but we can't hear you, Veena ji. Veena Naik ji, we can't hear from Veena ji. Vinayak ji, are we able to reach you? Jayanta ji, would you like to interact? Okay, maybe we... Ji,
hello.
Yes, sir, please.
Am I audible?
Yes, sir, you are.
Good morning, madam. Thank you for giving me the opportunity. Actually, I have a doubt. So is trust it is naturally acceptable always in all cases. I think it is not naturally acceptable for always and each all cases.
So Jayanta sir, let's look at this. When you look at yourself, let us ask this question to ourselves. When you look at yourself, what is naturally acceptable to you? Trust or
For me, madam, trust is acceptable for me. But is it naturally acceptable for all?
Let's see that. Let's see. We are in process of exploring. So let us first do it for ourselves. So when you are asking this question to yourself, what is naturally acceptable to you? Trust or mistrust?
Naturally trust, madam. Naturally trust.
Okay. Very fine. Very nice, sir. And now we are answering these questions. So let us explore and see about the other also through this whole self-exploration. Right?
Yeah.
So we'll spend some time, Jayanta ji, and we'll come back to this.
Yes.
Very nice.
Thank you.
These are very important issues where I am able to see about myself as well as the other. So I hope you have put your responses. Let us see what are your responses to these questions. These questions which we have seen earlier also, we are taking. So when we say, I want to make myself happy, question 1A, 96% can clearly see that, yes, I want to make myself happy. This is my want, right? My own natural acceptance is that I want to make myself happy. I want to make the other always happy. Again, 90% people are clearly mentioning that they want to make the other always happy. So question 2A is also with this tick, right? I can just see this. Question 1A and question 2A, I'm sure of it. Question 3A, the other wants to make himself, herself happy always, right? We can just see 90%, 82% saying that yes, they are able to see. Some are saying cannot say, they are not sure about the other, right? So since 82% are agreeing to this, we are putting it as a yes. And let's look at the fourth question, where we are looking at the other wants to make me happy. And we can see the ambiguity of the answers over here. 46% saying yes, 17% saying no, 37% mentioning cannot say. Now, all these questions are about our intention part, right? Now, let's look at the ability part. What I am able to do. These four questions were regarding what is naturally acceptable to me, the intention part, right? Let us look at the ability part. Ability part, what I am capable of doing right now. I am able to make myself happy always. Always means every moment, right? I'm able to make the other always happy every moment. Question 3B, the other is able to make himself, herself always happy. And question 4B, the other is able to make me always happy. It is about our ability, right? So let us respond to these questions. While you are taking time to respond to these questions, let us hear from some of you. Priya ji, would you like to interact?
Ma'am, am I audible?
Please.
Yeah. Ma'am, when I was taking this class to my student, actually one of these two, it was an online session, even with the natural acceptance, when I asked the fourth one, he was telling, ma'am, if I want to make others happy, just like my friend or my other colleague want to make me also happy, you know, so why there should be a doubt?
Very nice. If the other is clear about it, it's very nice.
Yeah, that was a student. That was a student's response, actually. I was thinking when we were in that workshop, we were having so much apprehensive whether that is true or false. But to the students, they could explore very well that actual acceptance. That was my experience, ma'am. In the class.
Very nice, Priyaji. We can just see that at times we have this assumption that probably the student will not understand it. In fact, with lesser preconditioning, they are far more quick to get the proposal.
Get the proposal, yeah.
Really Thank nice, sharing. Very nice, Priyaji. So we all can see. Okay, let us hear from Dr. Lata. Would you like to interact? Dr. Lata?
Yeah, good morning, ma'am. My feeling is, ma'am, just I want to reflect on this. So the conflict in the relationship comes. So if I extend the maximum, so to make the others happy, we extend at large. And in reciprocation, whether the intention of the we, in order to be holistic, we need to feel that the other intention is to make me happy. Though the other person knows that if we extend this help, I'll be happy, they are reluctant to do. So in such a case, wholeheartedly, if I am able to extend the maximum possible to make the other person happy, so though the other person knows this particular deed, if he completes, the person A will be happy, even if he knows that, so out of laziness, just taking it for granted. So like that, if they deny in making, so the person A happy, there the conflict occurs. That is how I feel, ma'am.
So, Lata ma'am, we are in process of getting more and more clarity for ourselves. Let's see, maybe another 10 minutes and we are touching upon what you are asking. It's very pertinent. In fact, you have asked this question and this question is running in so many of us together. So let's take that exploration further within us and try to see answers for ourselves.
Fine.
We'll just hold it for a moment so that we can have discussion further. So we can take, I hope all our participants have put their response before proceeding ahead. Let's hear from one. Okay, we have the responses to this. So when I look at this question 1B, I am able to make myself always happy. Always happy means every moment, not even a single moment you are unhappy. Are you able to do so every time? Let us see some responses in the chat box, because over here in this particular response, 82% have said yes. Let us see the responses which we get in the chat. Are you able to make yourself always happy? Over here, we are getting so many no's. In the response chat, we are getting so many no's over here. Maybe you couldn't get this question, that when I'm looking at my ability part, which means that every moment I am happy, this happiness is in continuation within me. Am I able to make that possible for myself right now? So many are saying that now we have understood the question. So we are putting a question mark to this. Why we are putting a question mark? Because I want to make myself always happy, but every time I'm not able to make myself happy. So there is this doubt on me. So looking at the second question, I'm able to make the other always happy. The other is always happy with whatever I do. Is it possible? So again, we are getting no's from so many of you. And that's why we are putting this question mark. Let's look at the question more carefully. Right, when it says always, it means every moment. Now, when we say that the other is always able to make himself, herself happy, it is about the ability part. Right? Abhijit sir is saying making happy always is a difficult one. Very true. We can see. So there are these question marks to question 3B also. And question 4B, the other is always able to make me happy. And we see big no's coming, right? We can just see that this is something which comes with a big no. So looking at this, this is what I am, my competence, right? My desire, my thought, my expectation, right? I want to make myself happy, but I am not able to make myself always happy, right? So I am lacking in ability part. But my want is clear, that is sacrosanct. Whatever I do, I want to make myself happy. This is my competence, that I'm unable to make myself always happy. Are you able to see that for yourself? Lata ma'am, are you able to see that?
Yes, ma'am.
Ji, very nice. We are taking your question only because that was part of the discussion and it is very, very pertinent and relevant question. If I look at my natural acceptance, I want to make myself happy every moment. This is my natural acceptance. But if I look at my ability, right, currently, every moment, can you say that you continue to be happy? Can you say that for yourself? Lata ma'am, can you say that for yourself?
Ma'am, can I just repeat my question?
See, I said that when I look at my want, I want to make myself happy, right? This is about my natural acceptance. I want this. But when I look at my ability, am I able to make myself always happy in continuity?
No, ma'am.
No. So there is this question mark. Very nice. Very nice. So there is this question mark on my ability, right? Regarding the other also, I want to make the other happy, but I'm not able to make the other always happy. And that's why there's a question mark over here, right? Similarly with the other also. Now, what we see is that whenever I'm looking at myself, I'm looking at my intention clearly, my natural acceptance clearly. Even though I'm lacking in ability, right, there is this clarity about my intention. But when I'm interacting with the other, I'm looking at the behavior of the other. The behavior of the other is what his competences, his ability is, right? What the other is. Now, looking at the behavior of the other, he is also falling short in terms of behavior, just like I am also falling short. But looking at his behavior, I'm putting a question mark at 4A, which means I'm doubting the intention of the other. And this doubt on intention is this mistrust. Are you able to see this for yourself? You can put response as yes or no. Are you able to see that for the other, I am looking at competence and doubting the intention of the other. And it is this doubt on intention of the other that is mistrust, which is leading to this whole anger, irritation within me. So when I say, when I look at the other's actions, I say, you broke the glass, right? So when the other is making the mistake even once, I have this doubt on intention. But when I look at myself, I say that I broke this glass by mistake. It dropped. Even if I'm making the same mistake 100 times, I'm never doubting my intention. I'm not doubting my intention. And I keep feeling that I am special. I keep reinforcing I am good. But with the other, I doubt the intention and I get this feeling of opposition, irritation within. Are you able to see this? Let us hear from you. Jasmine ji.
Good afternoon, ma'am. Actually, I have raised the hands to ask the previous question, and also I will connect to this question also. So we were talking about the feelings. So that is when we have the right understanding of our feelings, so we can respond properly to the other person. But my question was, I want to connect feelings with emotions. Mm-hmm. Suppose our emotions or feelings are happening due to some biological activity happening in our body or some hormone fluctuations due to aging or something like that. So how can, even though I know it is correct, but sometimes my emotions are not in my control. And after some time, maybe I will be realizing I should not have or something like that. So there will be a chance of our biological process happening in our body will be influence in our feelings and emotions and the reaction to the any situations or something like that. So I need the answer for this. And with respect to this particular context, the doubting the intention, So this also can happen. So we'll think that, okay, we may react due to our present health situation. The other person should have understood that. So that also we may think, and we expect the other person should realize it and respond it. So in both the context, I want your clarification.
So when we are looking at ourselves and we are seeing that there are some kind of changes within the body, and I am not just the body, right? With this clarity, I am able to take that decision for myself. Let's see that when you are clear with this, right? That you are not just the body, and this body is the instrument. Are you able to make the right utilization of the instrument?
Ma'am, that's what I want to tell that. See,
so if you are unwell, that's what I'm coming to. If you are unwell, right, somehow, are you able to see that currently the state of the body is such that it is unwell?
Yes.
And you can take the right decision for the body, right, without getting irritated? Can that response be done?
Ma'am, that's what I'm telling. So it's not only our body in the sense, I'm just talking about that biological process. Hormone fluctuations.
I'm referring to that. In any situation, if I'm aware of it, will I be reacting or responding?
We should respond, but that's what we want to respond, but it will result into sometimes reactions.
Which means that I'm lacking in ability.
Yes, to some extent, yes.
Which means I have to work on myself?
Yes.
Am I able to see this, that just like I lack in ability, the other can also lack in ability?
Yes.
Right? Now, once I'm able to see that the other is lacking in ability, just like I lack in ability, now I'm not doubting the intention of the other.
Okay.
Are you able to see this for yourself?
Ma'am, that's fine. But if it is once or twice, okay. If it's a regular experience or something like that.
Just hold on. Now, the more I become aware of myself, I start shifting from reaction to response. It may not happen all of a sudden, but the frequency will change. Right? So to begin with, maybe I react and then I realize that I react.
Yes.
But with this awareness, slowly I'm able to see, right, that time gap will reduce.
Okay.
Right? It may not happen overnight, that is for sure. Whatever you're mentioning is very true, that most of the times we react first and later on we are going to realize.
Yes.
But once I become aware of it, right, and I'm practicing it, right, it will require practice.
Okay.
Right. So when I'm practicing it, I'm becoming more and more aware of myself. I'm getting to know the reality, right? That I am taking the decision. So now I become more and more aware of myself. So now I can see clearly that the body is in a different state right now, but I'm not carried away with the state of the body, the fluctuations which I'm experiencing. So I'm responding. So if I need rest, I'll take rest. And I'll convey it to the other also with that harmony within me. That look, I am in this state and right now I need the rest for myself, whatever. But that can only be done when I'm aware of this reality, that the self is taking the decision and the body is following.
Yes, ma'am, I understood. Thank you.
Very nice. So looking at this whole discussion, right? Just like I am lacking in competence, working on myself, I have to raise my competence. But what we majorly do is we are doubting the intention of the other. And that is the major reason for problems in relationship. We may not speak to other for days. We may have even breakups in relationship. It is this doubt on intention which is a major reason for problem. Are you able to see this? Right? Let us take a quick response from you regarding this. We are asking this to our students also. We can just relate. Have you lost a number of good friends like this? So taking your reflection onto this poll, Can we have the poll, Bhaiya? So just see if this is happening to you too at times, where you are doubting the intention of the other. Does that happens to you too? While you're responding to this, let us quickly hear from Dr. Vedula Padmavati ji. Or maybe Professor Gautam Raj ji, any one of you, if we are able to reach you. Dr. Vedula Padmavati ji or Dr. Professor Gautam Raj?
Good morning, ma'am.
Good morning.
Yes, it often happens when others, when children by mistake, if they broke the glass in such a way. So always we take care whenever they touch that glass. That means we are having doubt within us whether they can hold it properly or not.
Very nice. We can see that we are doubting the intention of the other. And it is this doubt on intention which is which is leading to this anger, this irritation within me.
Yes, ma'am.
Very nice. Very nice.
Thank you.
So I hope all our participants have put their response to the chat, to the poll, because it is about to end. And we can see, does this happen to me too? And so many are saying that yes, it does happen to us, where we are doubting. So honest that we are able to see this, that at times we are doubting the intention of the other. And that becomes the major reason for problems. So we can just check. We can help the students also check. This is what we are doing, facilitating them. If you have unconditional, continuous trust on intention of the other, and the other is lacking in competence, what will you do? Try to improve his competence, get irritated, get angry, have this whole feeling of opposition. What do you think? While you're responding to this, let us hear from Prasanna Kumarji. Would you like to interact? Or maybe Gurleen Sindhuji?
Hello.
Yes, Prasanna.
Madam, good morning.
Good morning,
sir. Regarding Madam, natural acceptance and your ability, and also the, you know, others and myself, when we commit a mistake, naturally the human tendency is when others commit a mistake, definitely we will think in a negative way. That is the human tendency. Okay, so if I am committing the same mistake 100 times, as you said, we will say that is a by mistake it happened. So in this situation, how exactly we can able to overcome this type of negative attitude?
So Prasanna Kumar, sir, let's think about ourselves. Now, am I doing this? And is this something which is naturally acceptable to me? To doubt the intention part of the other, or to get the competence?
Madam, this is the intention part.
Is it naturally acceptable to us to doubt the intention of the other?
Though that is actually now what we are in a state that we are normally do that.
So the mistake which I was doing is because I was lacking the clarity.
Is the lacking the clarity means it is, you know, doubting others because of we have lack of understanding.
Very true. I am lacking this understanding, and that's why I'm doubting the intention of the other. If I have this understanding within me, where I understand these feelings clearly.
So we should have proper understanding about others, and we come to the natural acceptance also. So I, you know, I know my ability, so that I want myself always happy, and I want to make others also happy.
Ji.
How can I expect that herself or himself happy always? Because that depends on their ability or their this one. So and when I am respecting others, definitely I expect same respect from others also.
जी, we'll talk about respect in the upcoming session, sir, where we'll take up this part of the question regarding the trust.
Yeah.
Just like you mentioned, right? If I am able to see my intention clearly and my competence also, am I able to do so for the other? That is something which I need to ask myself.
Yeah, even I can say I have, you know, I can able to keep myself happy always. And because I understand the people so that I can able to make others also happy. Correct, no, madam?
So now you are able to see that your intention part is to make yourself happy as well as the other happy.
Others happy, yes.
Right? But when you look at your ability part, there may be times when you are not able to make yourself as well as the other happy. There may be some time, maybe lesser time, but some time.
Yes, right? yes.
Which means that ability and intention, there is some gap between the two?
Ability and intention, I say for myself and making others happy, there is no gap. But there is a gap when I expecting the other or himself or herself to be happy. And that is not depends on my ability.
Of course, it doesn't depend on your ability, but to see others' competence.
Yeah.
Do we have that ability?
Yes, madam. Yes, that is other competence. So,
are you able to see the competence of the other?
Okay. So, that competency we are getting just if we thoroughly understand the other people.
So, if I have this client, is it fine, sir?
Okay. Thank you.
Ma'am.
Thank you, madam.
Ma'am, may I share a quick reflection?
Please.
Ma'am, actually, I've been focusing on the intention, my intention and the other's intention. And, you know, at times I've realized that the other is lacking in competence. So I've tried to improve that as well. But I've seen eventually what has happened now is that when I see that the other is not ready to, you know, improve, kind of irritation has crept in. You know, I mean, rather than... it being helping me, I have observed that some way I now have started getting irritated that, okay, I mean, I do not doubt the intention, but now I am focusing on the competence level and I've realized that no matter what I do, this person is not going to, you know, change it. And somehow, which I did not like about myself, I am kind of feeling superior also that, you know, I can understand this and the other person, no matter how hard I've tried, is not able to get it. So I just wanted to share it that at times, you know, you're thinking that you're on the right track, focusing on the intention, but I ended up doing this. So now I'm kind of coming out of it. So I just wanted to share it with everyone because I feel maybe somebody else might also be going through the same situation. Thank you.
Very sincere sharing that we over-evaluate ourselves and somehow under-evaluate the other also. In fact, the next session will talk in more details about respect. So, Burleen ma'am, your sharing is very important, pertinent to me. Where we
thank you.
Somehow start looking at other and trying to feel that the other is lacking in competence every time. Right? So, we just need to evaluate ourselves also rightly. And we'll be looking at this. So when we look at the polls, we can just see that whenever we have unconditional continuous trust on intention of the other, we try to improve his or her competence. And that is what is a response. But if I have this doubt on intention of the other, then I'm reacting, which means I'm getting irritated, I'm getting angry, I'm having this feeling of opposition within. And we can just see within ourselves, how many persons do we really have trust on intention? Absolutely unconditional, which means I never ever get angry with them. And it is this trust on intention, which is the foundation of the relationship. So with all this discussion, we can enable the student also to have an understanding about this trust in relationship, right? Now, once we have this clarity that the other is also lacking in competence, just like I am lacking in competence, but intention-wise, the other is the same as I am. I have not created this intention or this natural acceptance. It is there within me. As a human being, I'm endowed with this Similarly, the other is also endowed with it. So the intention part is the same. This question 2A and question 4A are just the mirror copy. I want to make the other always happy. If I can say it, yes, it is my intention for the other. Question 4A is the other wants to make me always happy. It is about the other's intention for me. If I just flip I and the other, question 2A and 4A are the same. If I can see this, then I have this clarity about the intention of the other. And I can clearly see that the other is lacking in ability, just like I am lacking in ability. So I can clearly see the difference between intention and the competence of the other, right? And with this, now when I look at the other, I'm able to see that just like I broke the glass, the other also broke the glass by accident. Just like I can do the mistake because of this lack of competence within me, the other is also doing this mistake because of this lack of competence and not the lack of intention. Right? Now, when I see that the other is lacking in competence, I'm committed to improve, to help the other. But I also equally understand that I may have difficulty in explaining also. Maybe I'm unable to put forth the proposal correctly to the other so that the other can get clarity about it. So this trust on intention is the starting point for our mutual development. So now when we look at the issues with the students, when we are discussing, right, with this doubt on intention, that is leading to issues like mistrust on the other and the fear in relationship amongst friends. With their friends, right, they may ask for sharing of notes and the other says no. And then the friend says that, look, you are not my friend. I don't trust you. You can't even share your notes. Now, are we able to see that the other is lacking in competence in this case? So this, once we have this trust on intention, we are able to get rid of the root cause of these issues. When these students, they come to second year, all these issues are discussed in much more details in the course, the credit course, which is being introduced in the second year. Right? Let us look at the reason why this anger is arising. What do you think? This anger, this arises whenever there is the state of confusion, when we don't clearly differentiate between intention and competence, right? This looking at the lack of competence, we are doubting the intention of the other. But the solution lies in knowing that the other is just a human being like me, a coexistence of self and body. And the other self has the same natural acceptance just like me. The other is lacking that competence to fulfill their intention. Just like at times, I am also lacking in my own competence. Right? So when we have some desire and that desire doesn't get fulfilled, I want notes from my friend. And my friend doesn't give that notes. I get irritated. I get angry. Okay? But if I am able to see that the other has this right intention, but lack of competence, maybe he is afraid that I may read his notes. I may get more marks. Right? Now, at that point of time, I'm ready to re-examine my own desires, my own expectations. Is my expectation really right? Is the program to fulfill that desire correct or not? The desire which I have in me, am I justified in that desire? Have I developed the necessary competence within me? Okay. That is something which we can see. We can help the students to look at this. So let us take the reflection from you and hear from you. Regarding this, what do you think? So while you are responding to what is being discussed, let's hear from Dr. Snigdha Patnaik ji. Would you like to interact, Snigdha ji?
Good morning, ma'am.
Please, Snigdha ji, go ahead.
Ma'am, yes, I usually think and feel the same way when others say about anything. But this practice is sometimes let me feel that due to some reason or other, I mean, so that was not correct. Means that at that particular time, what had I had thought of, what had I had accepted was not correct. This happens very less time, means one or two times out of 100, but still sometimes this happens. Means so what you'll be taking for that?
In all that cases, we have to reflect whether we are able to clearly differentiating between intention and competence, or we are mixing the two with the other. Now, if I can see that I am wrongly evaluating others' competence and that has led to this gap, then I work on myself. Right?
Okay. Thank you.
Gee, very nice. So I hope you have put your response to this.
Ma'am, would you like me to speak?
Because, please, sir. Please go ahead, sir.
Can I see the slide?
Gee, sir.
1 minute. So what happens is that suppose you know that intention is not wrong. I would like to give one example. Like my son is there. And what he does is that he makes some mistakes, like sometimes, and without intention actually. But what happens, me and my wife always tell him about it. But after some time also, he doesn't get improved. Then at that time, we lose our patience. So from your deliberation, what I learned is that I have to improve my patience level there. Till the time he gets his action corrected.
Gee, so when you are interacting with your own child, right? Now,
yes.
The child may be doing mistake, but are you able to clearly see that intention-wise, the child also wants to make you happy?
He might be repeating those mistakes.
So you will... You will, once you are able to see that one program doesn't work, you will make another program with your own child.
Yes.
You have that clarity. But if you are lacking that clarity, you will get irritated maybe after 2 attempts, 3 attempts or 5 attempts.
Yes. Right? So that on our part, we lack actually to improve others.
That's what we have to see, that sometimes whatever I may do, maybe I am not capable of making the other understand. So I'll reprogram, I'll seek help from someone else.
Yes.
Very nice.
Thank you.
So with this, let us look at the home assignment which we are discussing with our students. So this home assignment which we are discussing, which will help them to further explore, where they see how many person in their own family do they have trust on intention, right? Which is absolutely unconditional, continuous, where you are able to look at your own competence as well as the competence of the other. Another important thing, in case you get angry, irritated, we can ask our students, right? These are assignments which are given as a part of the induction session where they look at themselves. So do you feel happy when you actually get angry? When you express your anger, are you feeling happy about it? We can ask this to the students. What is the outcome when you express your anger? Is it leading to any kind of mutual happiness? In our own families, we can just see whenever we are angry and we are expressing it, is it ensuring mutual happiness for ourselves as well as for the other? Right? And let us see what is the real reason for our anger. Is it the other who is responsible for this anger, or this anger is within us and we are responsible for it? Another assignment which the students are usually asked to do is to talk to 2 close friends you may have lost due to lack of trust and tell them that you have realized the difference between intention and competence and you want to reconnect. Just see what is their response, right? These are the assignments which we are giving to the students. Now, in all this discussion, there are some key points which we want to convey to our class, to our students. And these key points we are putting forth for you all to have a look at, that they are able to see that this relationship is between oneself and the other self. And fulfillment in relationship means that we are able to ensure happiness for ourselves as well as for the other. There are 9 values which we talk about in relationship, and these values are universal in every relationship, starting from this trust, which is the foundational value, moving on to the other values, respect, affection, care, guidance, one after the other. We looked at the definition of the trust to have the clarity that the other wants to make me happy. The difference between intention and competence, that we should be able to communicate, facilitate for our students. This trust on intention is in continuity. While the evaluation of competence will keep changing from time to time, right? And with the help of various little examples, we can facilitate our students so that they get clarity about this. Within our classrooms, these are some of the frequently asked questions. They may be your questions too. So we should look for right answers. What if someone breaks my trust? If I have trust in continuity, can that be broken? If I have trust on intention, can that change from person to person? Can I trust someone blindly? These are some questions which the students keep asking, right? So we look at these questions, we'll reflect within ourselves and look out for feasible answers which we can put forth for our students. So with all this discussion on trust, now we are moving on to the quiz for this particular session. Subhaya, can we have the quiz? Ji. So the quiz is here, 5 questions and 5 minutes.
Thank you, Didi, for the participant. A quiz is there, what we have discussed in this session, and 5 minutes is